Hey, welcome back to a new video. Someone asked below one of my videos if you can recreate or emulate a real superstar inside the grid of Bitwig Studio. And he also dropped me a link to a PDF with a pretty detailed explanation on how you can create such superstar wave. And this is how the PDF looks like, how to emulate the superstar. Okay, and there's a lot of information in there also where the SAR, Super SAR came from. The Roland JB8000, I think, is the first synthesizer that invented this. And also on different other synthesizers, they try to recreate a Super SAR and fail or just make small iterations to the original technique. So as we scroll down here, we have the Super SAR. The Super SAR oscillator present in the Roland synthesizers is created by layering 7 sawtooth oscillators and tuning their frequency apart from each other by a set amount, causing the resulting sound to sound thick and more powerful. It is especially used for creating string-type sounds and pads. Once the Super SAR is selected to be the active oscillator, the user can change 2 sets of controls, which alters the behavior of the sound, the tune and mix. So we have 2 macro controls to set up in our device, the tune and mix. With the tune, we can spread the voices apart or the oscillators apart, and with the mix we can bring in the additional oscillators in volume. So when we scroll down here, we have the detune section, and this describes how the oscillators are detuned. But this is pretty detailed, but to make it short, it's pretty simple. You have a center oscillator, as you can see here, number 4, with your key frequency. So when you press A3, you have 440 hertz, and then all the additional oscillators 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7 increasing basically or decreasing in frequency to detune them. So pretty easy tasks, and it's easy to do in the grid. Then we have the mix section here, which also says here, the Axis Virus TE Hypersaw allows one oscillator to be heard alone. However, it adds the oscillator's volumes one by one instead of all of them at the same time. So the original Super SAR, basically, when you gain the mix knob up, then you bring in all the 7 oscillators at once. And the middle oscillator, as you can see here, number 4, is decreased in volume slightly. And this is, I think, because why the sound is louder. You have now multiple oscillators playing at a different frequency, at a different loudness level, and then they sum up, and then you have in the end a higher level, so you can bring everything a bit down, so you have the same volume in the end when you bring in the mix knob. So this is a special thing to note, that we have to bring in all the additional oscillators at once instead one by one. And then we can also scroll down to the shape, as you can see here. This is a ordinary SAR wave or SAR shape, as you can see, but the B is in fact the Super SAR SAR oscillator. A is ordinary sawtooth wave, and B SAR from the Super SAR, and it's slightly rounded corners, as you can see here. And this is achieved, as described in this text here, that you need to go with the sound from the additional oscillator through an high pass filter. Research showed that the oscillators used in the Super Saw are in fact saw oscillators, but the added signal of the seventh waveforms goes through a high-pass filter. A way to achieve such a waveform without a high-pass filter is through a wavetable oscillator. But we can achieve this. We have a high-pass filter module in the grid, so we can use this. And then we go down to the phase part here. And the phase of an oscillator or wave denotes the offset of the displacement in the cycle of the oscillator. Yeah, this is clear. But when the super saw is playing a single note repeatedly, the difference in each note can be seen through a recording displayed in the time domain. So basically what this says is that every oscillator, yeah, you can see it in the graph. Every time you press a note, normally you trigger the oscillator from the start. You basically start at the right point in the phase. So you can see all the oscillators are similar or overlapping because they start at the same point. But with the super saw, we have to randomize the start point in the phase. So to achieve a sound that is typical to the super saw, the waveform must never be the same. The phase must receive a value that is different every time a note is triggered. Every time we press a key, every oscillator should be start at a different point in the phase. So this should be also no problem with the grid. And then there is, yeah, some additional notes and a bit of discussion. So very much, very deep informations on how to emulate the super saw. And I tried to recreate this inside BitWig Studio in the grid, and this is how it looks. I have seven saw oscillators here. I used a phaser, which gives us a saw-like shape. And they all go through this conversion here from uni to bipolar, so we have a full signal. And when I press a key on the keyboard, you can see we have different saw waves moving at different speeds because they are slightly detuned. And every time I press a key, we start at a different point in the phase. Also, the mix knob brings in all the additional oscillators, in fact these six here, at once. So this is changing, I think, this here. And then all these six additional oscillators are going into the mixer, and this mixer goes into a high pass filter. And this high pass filter is also set to key tracking. So every time we press a key, the filter changes the position to the accordingly to the key we are pressing. So this is also described in the PDF. So we have now six oscillators going through the high pass filter and the fundamental oscillator going straight out into the envelope here. And when we bring up the mix, we just raise basically the six oscillators at once. And we have a detune knob here at the bottom.